multiple sclerosis sufferer. The house was adapted because she is consigned to a wheelchair. The house was adapted to accommodate that, and nevertheless, Housing Association has informed them that they're going to have to find an extra £16 a week to pay. They don't have the money. The guys that are going to see their brother go to prison and pay the bedroom tax because he can't afford to pay it. Real people here we're talking about. Real people, real heartache, real despair. I think we as a community of ordinary people have to say, number one, we are calling on every council, we're calling on every housing association to say no evictions for bedroom tax arrears. It is a start that Dundee City Council, North Ayrshire Council, have now come out and openly declared that at least for the first 12 months there will be no evictions for bedroom tax arrears. Knowsley Housing Trust that Gordon mentioned, 566 properties of the 14,000 properties that they've got in Knowsley, they've decided to redesignate them so that three bedrooms become two bedrooms become one, and they're going to make sure that the 566 people that were going to be affected by the bedroom tax are not going to be affected by the bedroom tax. Brighton Council in the South Coast have said, full stop, we are not going to evict anybody who's got bedroom tax arrears. No, a 12-month thing, we're just not carrying evictions. Well, I've got to say to you, brothers and sisters, if Brighton Council can say no eviction, if Knowsley Housing Trust can redesignate homes, then why the hell can't the other councils and the other housing associations do the exact same so that we stop the house? That meetings like this have to exert and the demonstration on Saturday has to exert. I have to appeal to every one of you to get yourself to Glasgow Green at 11:30 on Saturday, to join the march to George Square, to say loud and clear to every council in Scotland, to say loud and clear to every housing association in Scotland, you must not implement this bedroom tax. Don't evict people who can't afford to pay. And then we go further. And we say as a community, actually, as an individual who's not affected by the bedroom tax, I can't say to you, don't pay it. I can certainly say that when it was a poll tax, because I wasn't paying it, and therefore I had no problem with a call for other people not to pay it. I can't call for you to do something I'm not doing myself. I'll tell you, I'll call for every single one of us to be prepared to stand shoulder to shoulder with any family that's threatening an eviction. Don't allow them to tough a family out into the street because they can't afford to pay their bedroom tax. We stood against the sheriff officers, the Rottweilers and Schutz, and we stopped them from carrying out poll tax warrant sales. Let's stop them again from carrying out any evictions.
And say, we'll continue.
of independence if people thought that there was a government that was prepared to stand up on the right side of justice instead of continuing to stand up with the billionaires. So I would appeal to the SNP government to support that petition and to make that change in the law. They say, well, if we do that, housing associations will lose revenue, councils will lose revenue, and so they will. But that's not the fault of poor and disabled families. That's what they should be fighting for from the Westminster government, compensation for any lost revenue. They tell us under independence of people bedroom tax, well, that's fine, we're going to have to compensate them anyway in relation to that. That's one of the demands we've got to march for on Saturday, brothers and sisters. If we build a campaign that has anti-bedroom tax committees in every scheme across Scotland, every community across Scotland, we've already got about 26 set up. We need 260 set up. We need phone trees. We need Facebook pages. We need Twitter accounts attached to each and every one of us, so that we can keep together and be prepared to unite against anything that the sheriff officers try and threaten families with. The only way we're going to defeat this is by solidarity, people power, sticking together. You know, we had our founding meeting, we set up a Western Scotland Federation of Anti-Bedroom Tax Committees on the 13th of March. We had a meeting of about 120 in Glasgow. And there was a woman stood up at the meeting, I'm going to finish on this point. There was a woman stood up at the meeting. Fiona Jordan, she won't mind me saying this because she's now became the chairperson of the West of Scotland Anti-Bedroom Tax Federation. Never been involved in politics in her life. Hadn't ever spoken at a political meeting in her life. Doesn't particularly like politics, but she lost her job a few years ago, she had an illness. Now in a housing association home, and she helps with her grandchildren. Some of you have been in the same boat. And the reason she's got a spare bedroom in her house is so the kids can stay. Think about this. Think about the number of families across Scotland when you have a marriage that just doesn't work. It happens. And what happens then is the kids suffer, don't they? Because do they go with the mum, do they go with the dad? And most couples try and come to an arrangement whereby children see the mum and see the dad. So most parents try and have a flat or a house that they have a bedroom, that they can have the main staying with them. Well, if they're in a social housing centre, a council house or a house association, and they're in that boat, and they've not got permanent custody, they're going to get charged for trying to give a wee bit of comfort for kids. Grandparents who have maybe had a two or three bedroom house, the family's away, you're helping the kids. There's one case at the Brock and Irvine last Thursday where a single parent, two kids, full time nurse, her mother has to take the kids, or else the mother can't work. But the mother's in a housing association house, herself, with two bedrooms. She's getting hit with an extra £14 a week, she can't afford to pay it. The housing officer that went to see her says, well, you'll need to charge your daughter. That's what we're reducing ourselves to. What used to be taken for granted, families stick together and help each other, you'll get charged for it. That's what the making has become. And that's why when Fiona Jordan stood up at that meeting and made a very impassioned contribution about how frightened she was but how determined she was to fight, she finished with something I'm going to finish with. She says, I've only got one thing to say to you today. She says, if you'll stand with me, I'll stand with you. Thank you very much.